imagine, if you will, a part dystopian, part post-apocalyptic world where the once separate governments across the globe joined together to form a new world order. Although some think that the governments were replaced by a new entity, so to speak. But whatever the case may be, they started to ban all of the freedoms and various forms of entertainment that brought people so much joy and pleasure. And they did this slowly over time. First, they started with sugar, candy, soda pop, etc. And then sandwiches, snacks. But just when you thought it couldn't get any worse, that's when they put a ban on movies. Now, there are some of those who think it's not such a bad thing, depending upon what type of movie it is, like the emoji movie, for example, or The Human Centipede number 3, or Cocktail. The list goes on and on of bad movies. Of course, it all depends upon your subjective view. But you know all of this, don't you? And that's why you're here. People call me the movie man. But you, you, my newfound friend, can call me the movie man. So, have you met my other brothers? The candy man, the sandwich man, anything man, nothing man. Okay. What about video game man? Okay. Well, just like them, I also have brought you a sample of a very small percentage of the millions of movies that have ever been made throughout the history of humankind. Now, I must say one thing. The only movies available that I can get for you are limited to the way back a few millennia. Back to the 21st century, 2019, to be exact. Any movies created after that time, whether it's the 22nd century or the 143rd century, are off limits under very high security. Even I can't get into those warehouses, which means security is a little bit lax and a little more loose with some of the older movies and the warehouses that they are stored in. So what I'm going to do here in this meeting with you is show you a sample of some of the movies that are available. Of course, any movie that you can think of, I can try to get for you, but these ones are more readily available, and I can make duplicates of them for you. I have about a dozen or so with me. And then once I go through each one and tell you a little bit about them, just in case you're not familiar with them, I'll go ahead and take your order at the end of this little meeting of ours here in this undisclosed location. How does that sound? Okay. And then I will arrange for someone to get in contact with you to perform the exchange. As you know, currency is no longer of any use. So you'll have to come up with something to trade. It's a bartering system. All right. All depending upon how many movies that you will be ordering today. How does that sound? Sound good? Okay. Do you have any questions before we get started? I don't know what's up with this red string. It leads all the way back to Arkham Sanitarium for some reason, and into one of the walls. I can't cut it, and I can't yank it out of the wall as hard as I try. I don't really know what that means, but it hasn't really prevented me from conducting business. So, myself and our Father, our Creator, Creator of us clones, are having discussions with Professor Clemens at the sanitarium to try and find out the meaning of this red string. So we'll see where that leads to. All right, well, all that aside, let me just set this aside and we'll get started, okay? All right, just a moment. I take it, obviously, by you being here, that you made it out of your district or quarantine zone safe enough. Cinema. Classic. Timeless. Classic. Should be in everyone's collection. And that is Airplane. Are you familiar with this movie? It is considered by many, especially back in the 19th and 20th centuries, to be one of the greatest comedies of all time. This happens to be the Don't Call Me Shirley edition. And let me read off the back of it to you and some of the special features this edition has. Do you like movies about gladiators? It's the Don't Call Me Shirley special collector's edition of that high-flying smash hit comedy farce, Airplane. Robert Hayes and Julie Haggerty join panicky passengers, inept ground controllers, and an inflatable autopilot named Otto, of course, in the disaster film spoof voted one of the 10 funniest movies ever made by the AFI, American Film Institute. Surely you won't find a funnier film on Blu-ray, and Don't Call Me Shirley. There is commentary by producer John Davison and writers-directors Jim Abrahams, Jerry Zucker, and David Zucker. Also, the long-haul version includes deleted scenes, interviews, and more, and a trivia track. So, the classic Airplane is available if you are interested. Selection of the Festival de Cannes, and it is called Border. This fairy tale is simply unmissable, quoted by the Awards Daily. It is a film by Ali Abbasi. You'll have to forgive my pronunciation. Also certified fresh by Rotten Tomatoes. Allow me to read the synopsis. Sense something beautiful. Here, let me show you the back. Okay. Sense something beautiful. Tina, played by actor Eva Melander. Again, you'll have to forgive my pronunciation. Is a border guard who has the ability to smell human emotions and catch smugglers. When she comes across a mysterious man played by Eero Milanov with a smell that confounds her detection, she uncovers a mystery. The dark secret about mankind and her own past. Quote, Eva Melander gives the most astonishing performance of the year by IndieWire. And this was released way back in, let's see if there is a date on this, 2019. It is quite a unique film. It is also based on a book by an author with the last name of Lindqvist, who I believe also wrote Let Me In, or Let the Right One In. these anthologies. One of the more notable aspects of this film is the special effects and makeup that were used for the main character and the new individual that she finds. And a very good setting as well, very unique story. I'm not going to repeat myself, so I'll just say this once. If you consider yourself a movie fan and you love all kinds of movies and you haven't seen this, you should consider ordering it. Okay. Oh, and just so you know, I do offer a rental service. 1 week, okay? Alright, so, border, okay? Just think about if it's something you wish to have in your collection. Something a little more on the artistic side. This is Eraserhead by director David Lynch, who you may be familiar with. Directed Mulholland Drive as well as the TV show Twin Peaks, with Twin Peaks The Return probably being better of the series. This movie, Eraserhead, is in black and white, was filmed back in 1977, so the 20th century. This is considered the Criterion Collection edition. The Criterion Collection is dedicated to gathering the greatest films from around the world and publishing them in editions of the highest technical quality with supplemental features that enhance the appreciation of the art of film. With this edition, of course, not only do you get the Blu-ray disc, but there's also 4K and, let's see if this will cooperate. Okay, it's the wrong side. Let me just open this up here. Not only that interview, it itself, but some photos, behind the scenes photos of the production of the film. So if you know someone that is a big fan of David Lynch or the film, then this could be something that you wish to order just as a gift. Small group of children case in rural England, these unique children are being studied and subjected to cruel experiments. When the base falls, one little girl escapes and must discover what she is, ultimately deciding both her own future and that of the human race. As a special feature, unwrap the secret world of the girl with all the gifts featurette. So it's a 2K, 1080p, widescreen, etc. So again, if you are not just a fan of movies, but like a lot of the zombie flicks, you'll definitely want to see this and perhaps add it to your movie collection. Okay. It's quite a unique story, a unique, interesting ending. And I think I'll just leave it at that without giving too much away. Okay. Is visit to Arkham Sanitarium. Okay. next movie. he neglects his job with a vengeance and is quickly promoted to upper management. This Blu-ray special features posted pandemonium, the apathy of man trivia track, games, 8 deleted scenes, and the original theatrical trailer. Okay, so Office Space, that's available for you to order. This next movie is quite unique. Comes from director Park Chan-wook. It is an Asian-based film. It is called Old Boy. And in case you're not familiar with it, allow me to read off the back. Tartan Asia Extreme Winner Grand Prix du Jury Cannes of 2004. Quote, a tense, no holds barred, knuckle gnawing roller coaster ride. Truly astonishing. A man is inexplicably kidnapped and imprisoned for 15 years, and his wife is brutally murdered. On his release, he is given a wallet full of money and a mobile phone. A stranger calls and asks him to try and figure out why he was imprisoned. A girl appears and promises to help him solve the enigma and seek vengeance for his cruel fate. As the search progresses, the man finally comes face to face with his kidnapper, who proposes a game. If the man discovers the reason for his imprisonment, his kidnapper will kill himself. If not, then the girl will be killed. He has only 5 days to unravel the mystery. Very unique story. A lot of interesting twists and, of course, a very interesting ending and reveal. This is the original Old Boy. There was also an American remake of it, I believe. This is, of course, in, I'm not sure if it's, let's say, it's Korean language with English subtitles. That's really the only way, the best way, I would recommend to watch this film. Okay. No special features, really. Oh, well, there are some deleted scenes with commentary, a trailer, and 3 times audio commentaries and an English dub option. Okay. Old Boy, that's available. We should be halfway through now. This next film is another quite unique film. Labyrinth by director Guillermo del Toro, who also did Hellboy, had an animated series on Netflix, I forget the name of that offhand. Let me show you the back here. It has it's quite a unique story and a lot of amazing special effects, creature effects, makeup effects, things of that sort. And this film also won 3 Academy Awards. So I'll read off the back. From acclaimed director Guillermo del Toro comes one of the most exciting and visually impressive adult audience fables since the Lord of the Rings movies, quoted by Richard Roper of Ebert and Roper. Following a bloody civil war, young Ophelia, the girl who is pretty much the star of the film, enters a world of unimaginable cruelty when and she moves in with her new stepfather, a tyrannical military officer. Armed with only her imagination, Ophelia discovers a mysterious labyrinth and meets a faun who sets her on a path to saving herself and her ailing mother. Soon, the line between fantasy and reality begins to blur, and before Ophelia can turn back, she finds herself at the center of the ferocious battle between good and evil. This has some special features. Video prologue by the writer, director Guillermo del Toro. Feature audio commentary by the writer and director Guillermo del Toro. There's a featurette. There's an interview with the filmmakers, DVD comics, director's notebook, multi-angle storyboard, and thumbnail compares, VFX plate compare, and galleries. So if you have or haven't seen this, it's definitely worth renting from me. Or if you've seen it, then it's definitely worth ordering and owning in your collection. Okay? Pan's Labyrinth. Getting close to the end here. There's five more to go. Next film is a classic by director Alfred Hitchcock. Psycho. This is the Steelbook edition. Meaning it has this. Next movie we have is what you might consider a cult classic. The Rocky Horror Picture Show. This, when it was played in the theaters back in the 20th century, audiences would actually interact with the film by throwing things at the screen and some other things I can't remember. Let me see. So this is the Blu-ray digital HD version, in case you never seen it, I'll show you the back. Allow me to read the synopsis. Give yourself over to absolute pleasure. Fasten your garter belt with a time-warping, gender-bending cult classic starring Tim Curry, who has always played some very memorable characters and performances. Also, Barry Bostwick, Susan Sarandon, and Meatloaf. The musician. The picture-perfect Blu-ray specimen includes an abundance of extras to help you recreate the midnight movie experience at home. Quote, it was great when it all began, end quote. And 4 decades later, this was actually filmed and released in 1975. Rocky Horror is still guaranteed to thrill you, chill you, and fulfill you. Here are some sinfully special features. Includes both the US and UK versions of the film. The Midnight Experience, the late night double feature, picture-in-picture show. Vintage callback track, unrated prop box, trivia track. Rocky Oak, sing it, like karaoke. Mick Rock, a photographer. Mick Rock's picture show, a gallery, press book and poster gallery, audio commentary, deleted scenes and outtakes, alternate black and white opening, alternate credit ending and misprint ending, Rocky Horror double feature video show, Beacon Theater, New York City, and Time Warp music video, and more. So, if you're looking to do the Time Warp again, then you might want to consider ordering this, okay? Or if you've never done the Time Warp to begin with, now's your chance, all right? Three more to go. Another classic by director Martin Scorsese. Starring Robert De Niro. Taxi Driver. In case you are, let me show you the back there. Okay. This was originally released in 1976, 20th century. Let me tell you the synopsis in case you are not familiar with the movie. Let's see. Winner of the prestigious Golden Palm at the Cannes Film Festival 1976 and nominated for 4 Academy Awards, including Best Picture 1976. Taxi Driver stars Robert De Niro in Martin Scorsese's classic film of a psychotic New York cabbie driven to violence by loneliness and desperation. Co-starring Jodie Foster, Albert Brooks, Harvey Keitel, Peter Boyle, and Sybil Shepherd. There are special features here with all-new 40-minute Taxi Driver Q&A featuring Martin Scorsese, Robert De Niro, Jodie Foster, and many more, recorded live at the Beacon Theater in New York City at the 2016 Tribeca Film Festival. Original 1986 commentary with director Martin Scorsese and writer Paul Schrader. Recorded by the Criterion Collection. Commentaries by writer Paul Schrader and by Professor Robert Kolker. Martin Scorsese on Taxi Driver. Producing Taxi Driver. God's Lonely Man. Taxi Driver Stories. Travis's New York. Travis's New York locations, theatrical trailer, Making Taxi Driver, storyboard to film comparisons with Martin Scorsese introduction, and animated photo galleries. So if you happen to be a fan of Martin Scorsese's films, especially Taxi Driver, or you haven't seen it, definitely a must watch, and I would have to say definitely worth owning and having in your collection, okay? Taxi Driver. This is definitely worth seeing and owning. So that's the front. See all the different quotes about it. And show you the back here. Okay. And this is a Yeon Sang-ho film. Let's see. It is Korean. Okay, so another Korean film. I'll read the back here to you in case you haven't seen it and are interested. Everything you could possibly want a zombie film to be, quoted by The Telegraph. When a mysterious virus breaks out across the country, the infected turn into the murderous undead. A few terrified travelers find themselves trapped on a bullet train from hell. And that's one of the things that makes this unique, is that everything takes place on a train. Not too many films like that. Fighting for their lives as hordes of the living dead crash towards them, crawling closer with every stop. Suspicion is rife. And tensions run high, as some will do anything to survive and make it to this safe zone. So it's quite a wild ride, no pun intended, when it comes to the zombie, post-apocalyptic zombie genre. Definitely, like I said, worth seeing, perhaps even owning, depending upon how much you like it, okay? Train to Busan. Bonus features, behind the scenes. That's a wrap, and in English language is available. But it's best watched, in my opinion, in the original language with subtitles. Movie that I brought with me for you to possibly order, and I will be returning again periodically. We have another, perhaps somewhat of an unknown film. This one is called What We Do in the Shadows. Somewhat of a comedy where vampires, four different vampires, think they're friends, I'm not sure if they're family, are living in a house. And well, let me read the synopsis to you. So we have the back. Okay. It's quoted as the best comedy of the year by The Guardian. And it's somewhat of a mockumentary, you might say. It's quoted as this millennium's answer to the Rocky Horror Picture Show, hysterical and unbridled lunacy, by the National Post. It also was the official selection of Sundance 2014. We SXSW 2014 and a People's Choice Midnight Madness Award 2014 Toronto International Film Festival. It also has over 100 minutes of bonus features, poster gallery, photo album interviews, video extras, promo videos, and deleted scenes. Only the New Zealand Documentary Board would take a stake in an up-close and personal under-the-cape look at four vampires and a guy named Stu bringing several thousand years of collective baggage into a shared living space. The dynamic of being undead while dealing with a duty wheel disposing of their unique leftovers is a chore, and the constant threat of fatal sunburn keeps Vlad and the other lads at each other's throats. Flight of the Conchords film, Jemaine Clement and Taika Waititi of Eagleverse Shark and Boy have created a timeless or even eternal comedy. Naturally, this film would be best enjoyed on a plasma TV. So, like dark comedies, a little bit of violence, and like I said in the very beginning, if you're just a fan of all kinds of movies, then this is again another must watch and perhaps even a must own, depending upon how much you like it, okay? What We Do in the Shadows. And that will do it. So give me a moment. Let me just take out my order form. So go ahead and take your order. Anything you see there that interests you? Yeah. Once I'm done meeting with all the other potential customers, then I'll send someone to arrange for the drop-off location. Make sure you bring something worthy of trading for all of those movies, okay? And I'll be back periodically, perhaps the end of this year. We'll see. Okay, well, it's a pleasure doing business with you, and good luck making it past the checkpoints on your way back home. They've been stepping up security lately. Someone was actually caught with some of the things that they've ordered from myself and my other brothers. So I'm not sure what became of them. Just be careful, okay? And hopefully see you again soon. Alright, take care. If you'll excuse me, I have to get ready for next customer.